Welcome to this lecture series in Chemical Reaction Engineering. We'll begin with problem number 5.21 from the exercise. We are planning to operate a batch reactor to convert A into R. This is a liquid reaction. The stoichiometry is given as A gives R, and the rate of reaction is given in the table. We'll see that data. How long must we react each batch for the concentration to drop from Ca0 is equal to 1.3 moles per liter to Ca final value 0.3 moles per liter. Batch reactor model, we know T is equal to Ca0 integral 0 to xA dxA by minus RA. In terms of concentration, it is minus Ca0 to Ca dCA by minus RA. If I plot 1 upon minus RA and x axis concentration, so Ca0 to Ca, here Ca0 is 1.3, Ca or Ca final is 0.3, so 1.3 to 0.3, if I plot 1 upon minus RA and measure or find out this area under the curve, this give me the value of T directly, batch time. So we want to find out how long we must react, that means we have to find out time. This is the data provided, concentration and minus RA value. 1 upon RA, reciprocal of this we have tabulated, and we have to plot 1 upon minus RA on one axis and CA on x axis. Ca0 is 1.3, here 1.3. Ca is 0.3 here, and batch reactor, so this area under the curve we can measure, and this is valid for both batch reactor as well as plug flow reactor. Here we are asked to find out in batch reactor what will be the time. So it will be same in PFR also, but as the question is on batch reactor, we'll write here batch reactor. Okay, so it comes out to be 12.4 minutes. For plug flow reactor, it will be designated as tau, space time. Next, 5.22. Now the same problem, same data of 5.21, we have to use it for finding out the size of plug flow reactor now. Needed for 80% conversion of the feed stream at 1000 moles per hour, and Ca0 is now 1.5. If Ca0 is 1.5, 80% conversion, unconverted Ca or Ca final, whatever notation you want, you can use, it will be 0.3. Okay, 80% converted, 20% unconverted is 0.3 moles per liter. Exactly same plot. So for this problem, same plot you are using. We know the performance equation or model for plug flow reactor. Tau is equal to Ca0 integral 0 to xA dxA by minus RA. Same minus Ca0 to Ca dCA by minus RA. Okay, if you make this plus sign, this becomes Ca to Ca0. Graphical representation here, this is 1.5 to 0.3. So this area under the curve complete. This is tau, space time for plug flow reactor you can find out. And once you find out space time, you can find out volume. Fa0 is 1000 moles per hour. This is moles per hour. Okay. And we are provided with the data. A gives R in batch reactor, and same data which is taken in the batch reactor is used. That means the same kinetics same reaction we are carrying out in different reactors. So same data I can use. So moles per hour I can convert into moles per minute, 16.67. volume, okay, V by FA0 is tau by CA0. So V is tau into FA0 by CA0. So tau is area under the curve, okay, this 1 upon minus RA value, that is given. And 17 multiplied by FA0, this is in moles per minute, because minus RA is given in moles per liter per minute. CA0 1.5, so 188.93 for plug flow reactor. Next, problem number 5.23. So here it is in three parts, A, B and C. Same data we have to use, so same curve we will use and evaluate whatever is asked. So part A is, what size of mixed flow reactor is needed for 75% conversion? CA0 is equal to 1.2 moles per liter. 75% conversion of that means 25% will be unconverted. So CA final value will be 0.3. Okay. Feed rate is this. Now mixed flow reactor, as plug flow reactor, if we use this curve 1 upon minus RA as a function of CA, this area under the curve is used for batch reactor or plug flow reactor. But there is no integral sign in MFR, so this rectangle, and rectangle, this value at the exit, exit is 0.3. So from here till you start from 1.2, so on this line, so this rectangle complete you have to find out, and that will give you tau for mixed flow reactor. So it is simply this multiplied by this dimensions x. So here 1.2 minus 0.3 is 0.9, and on y axis it is 2 units. So 0.9 into 2, 1.8 minutes only. This is same 1000 moles per hour. Volume you can find out, just replace this, rest CA0 is changed, now it is 1.2. So for mixed flow reactor 75% conversion, if you start with 1.2 moles per liter and with the feed rate of 1000 moles per hour, you get volume as 25 liter. Second question, part B. Repeat part A with the modification that feed rate is doubled. Now feed rate is double. Earlier it was 1000 moles of A per hour. Now it is 2000 moles of A per hour. CA0 is 1.2. Okay. And it is to be repeated for same is 75% conversion. So part B, 1.2, 75% conversion, again same value 0.3. Now feed rate is doubled, 2000. Okay, here there is no change, so tau will not change. Same curve and 1.2 to 0.3, area of this rectangle same. FA0 is 2000, so it is doubled, so this will also double. Earlier it was 16.67, now it is 33.33 moles per minute. This you have to convert into minutes, because rate law is moles per liter per minute. So volume is tau value same, CA0 is same, this value is changed, doubled. So 50 liters. So naturally the volume will be doubled. Part C. Repeat part A with the modification that CA0 is 2.4 now. CA0 is doubled. This is same, 1000 moles per liter. And final value is again same as the earlier problem, that is 0.3. Only CA0 is changed. Now part C here. CA0 is 2.4. This is 0.3, same as earlier. This is same as earlier. So this you can extend further and further. It will be almost constant. We assume that the trend is maintained, or you can calculate and find out. So we are not bothered about area under the curve, we want this area of the rectangle again. Now what is the change? Earlier it was 1.3 to 0.3, now it is 2.4 to 0.3. So this is change, this is same, 2 units. So 2 units multiplied by 2.1, so 4.2 minutes. This is 4.2 minutes. FA0 is 1000, so 16.67. CA0 is now new value 2.4, and this volume comes out to be 29.17 liters. So same data of batch reactor from problem 5.21 we have used for 5.22 and 5.23. In 23 there were 3 parts for the mixed flow reactor. 5.24. High molecular weight hydrocarbon gas A is fed continuously into heated high temperature mixed flow reactor, where it thermally cracks homogeneous gas reaction into lower molecular weight materials, and those products collectively we call them R. Okay. So by stoichiometry A gives 5R. 1 mole of A gives 5 mole of R. By changing the feed rate, different extents of cracking are obtained. The data is obtained by changing the feed rate. Internal void volume, so reactor volume, is V is equal to 0.1. So in a cracker there will be catalyst, and void volume will be the volume which is actually 0.1 liter. At the temperature of the reactor, the feed concentration is 100 millimole per liter. Find the rate equation to represent this reaction. Now this data is given, FA0 and CA. Okay. CA is 1630 and so on. CA0 is 100. So we can calculate XA. Reaction is 1 mole gives 5 mole, so we have to bother about epsilon A, and this epsilon A is 5 minus 1 by 1, and that is 4. So you have 400% increase. So for mixed flow reactor, tau is equal to V by V0 CA0 XA divided by minus RA. Okay. So this minus RA I can write as V0 CA0 XA by V. V0 CA0 is FA0. FA0 is known. XA you can calculate. How will you calculate XA? With the equation, you know CA is equal to CA0 into 1 minus XA divided by 1 plus epsilon XA. And similarly, XA you can find out 1 minus CA by CA0 divided by 1 plus epsilon A into CA by CA0. That we have used many times. And you know FA0, you have calculated value of XA, and volume is known. So find out minus RA. And once you know minus RA and CA, you can find out ln of minus RA, ln of CA. So for nth order rate law, minus RA is equal to KCA raised to N. We can find out the rate law. Okay. This XA 1 minus CA by CA0 divided by 1 plus epsilon A into CA by CA0. Epsilon A value is 4. This is substituted here. CA by CA0. CA0 is 100. And this data. Ln of minus RA. Ln of minus RA will, in y is equal to mx plus c form, m is slope and slope is directly the order. Ln of k, anti-log e raised to k, exponential k will give you, exponential of this value, intercept will give you the value of k. So this is plotted. This is the best fit equation, 1.011x plus 4.564. So this slope we can take approximately as 1.011. K, exponential k is 4.564. This is 96. So minus RA is equal to 96 CA. First order, and 96 is first order rate constant. So we have determined the rate law from the given data. Next, 5.25. The aqueous decomposition of A is studied in an experimental mixed flow reactor. So now the data is from the mixed flow reactor. Results are given in the table for steady state runs. To obtain 75% conversion of the reactor in a feed, Ca0 is equal to 0.8 moles per liter. What is the holding time needed in plug flow reactor? So we have to find out tau for plug flow reactor. Data is Ca0, Ca and tau value. So from this, we can find out minus Ra. Data is from the mixed flow reactor. So mixed flow reactor, what is the performance equation? Simply Ca0 xA by minus Ra. Okay. So you find out minus Ra value and then find out 1 upon minus Ra value. Okay. And then we make a plot of 1 upon minus Ra as a function of Ca concentration. So we have this curve. Now Ca0 is 0.8 and 75% conversion of that. Okay, unconverted is 25%. 25% unconverted means 0.8 into 0.25. That is 0.2. So we start with 0.8 and final value is 0.2. So for mixed flow reactor, you have to find out the area of complete rectangle. But we are asked here, the question is, to obtain 75% conversion of the reactant, feed Ca0 is equal to 0.8 moles per liter. What is the holding time needed in plug flow reactor? So for plug flow reactor, this area under the curve will give you tau value. So 295 seconds, because here tau is in seconds. So that is the result which we were asked to find out. So area under the curve, this is reported. This value is actually counting the number of these rectangles and multiply by the area of one rectangle. So area of one rectangle will be the least count on this side and this side. This is 0.2. Okay. Means one unit is 0.04 and here it is 500, means one unit is 100. So area of one rectangle multiplied by, you count the number. So complete rectangles you first count, then just by judgment this half almost and almost half you can count as one. So its base, it depends on how carefully you do it and how you approximate these rectangles, which are fractions, partial. So depending on that, my value is 295 plus minus 2% error on either side is the finally acceptable answer when you use the graphical method, and particularly you count the area under the curve for plug flow or batch reactor. For mixed flow it is simple, area of rectangle. So that will be unique value. Anyone calculates, that will be unique value. Here area under the curve plus minus 2% error is acceptable. Okay. Next, 5.26. So we have to repeat the previous problem. Now for mixed flow reactor. Earlier it was for plug flow. Mixed flow it is simple. So this 0.8 minus 0.2 is 0.6. And y-axis this value complete 2000. So it is 1200 seconds. 5.27. So this problem, listen carefully, I will read out the problem for you. It's a case study and a little bit detective kind of thing. Holmes, he says, you say he was last seen tending in this vat. Vat means a reactor, nearby reactor. Boss says, you mean overflow stirred tank reactor. Mr. Holmes, you must excuse my ignorance of a particular technical jargon. So he is not aware of the technical name, overflow stirred tank reactor or a stirred tank reactor. That's all right. However, you must find him. So this one person, operator, is missing. His name is Imbibit. Imbibit was a queer chap, always starting into the staring into the reactor, taking deep breaths and licking his lips. But he was our very best operator. Why? Since he left, the conversion of googly ox, the product, has dropped from 80% to 75%. So there is 5% drop in the conversion of this reactant. Since this operator is left or not seen, there is a drop of 5% in the conversion. So earlier the conversion was 80%, now the conversion is 75%. Then Holmes says, by the way, what goes on in the vat? There is a chemical reaction going on. Just an elementary second order reaction, he tells. So second order reaction is taking place between ethanol and googly ox. If you know what I mean, of course, maintain a large excess of alcohol, about 100:1. Holmes says, we checked every possible lead in town and found not a single clue. So why this conversion is dropped? They worked on every possibility and still clueless. Boss says, we'll give the old chap a raise, about 2 pence per week, if only he will come back. So he's missing. Pardon me, but may I ask you a question? Why? Certainly, Watson. What is the capacity of this vat? He asked to the boss. 100 imperial gallons. So capacity is 100 imperial gallons. We always keep it filled. That is why we call it overflow reactor. You see, we are running at full capacity and profitable operation. Well, my dear Watson, we must admit that we are stumped, for without clues, deductive powers of no avail. So they have worked on all the possibility to find out the reason why the conversion is dropped from 80% to 75%. So 5% drops means this profitable operation is now going in losses. But there is where you are wrong. Imbibit was a largish fellow, say about 18 stone. Now this 18 stone is the weight of Imbibit, the missing operator. Why? Yes, how did you know? It is quite elementary, Holmes. We have all the clues necessary to deduce what happened to the happy fellow. But first of all, would someone fetch me some deal? With Sherlock Holmes and Sir Boss impatiently waiting, Dr. Watson casually leaned against the vat and slowly, carefully filled his pipe. And with the keen sense of dramatic, he lit it. There the story ends. So this is a story of what happened in that plant around the reactor. Now the question is, what momentous revelation was Dr. Watson planning to make? And how did he arrive at this conclusion? Why did he never make it? So you read the problem statements, the complete story carefully, and then go to the solution. So we'll see here. Reaction, it is mentioned elementary second order. So k tau 1 or k tau, you can say xA1 upon 1 minus xA1, or k tau is equal to xA by 1 minus xA1. Earlier conversion was 80%. So k tau 1 for 80% conversion, we are considering it was 4. Next, second, that is xA2 is 75%. So 0.75, 1 minus 0.75, k tau 2. So we have these two values now. Earlier case and now what is happening? V2 by V1 is tau 2 by tau 1. And if you do this, V2 is 75 gallons. Why? This 100 gallons is the initial volume. It is given 100 imperial gallons. Decrease in volume is 25 gallons. Okay. So this is converted, gallon is converted into cubic feet. Okay. Multiplying factor is 0.160544. This conversion factors you can find from Google conversion charts. So one gallon is this many cubic feet. So 25 gallons is 4.0136 cubic feet. You can approximate it as 4 cubic feet also. Then density of human body is same, considered almost same as density of water. That is in pounds per cubic feet, 62.4. This also you can find from Google. 18 stones was his weight, it was mentioned. One stone means 14 pounds. So his weight will be 18 stone into 14 pounds, means 18 into 14 pounds. This, if I divide by the density in pound per cubic feet, his volume of his body is 4.038 cubic feet. Okay. Decrease in volume, decrease in conversion, because of decrease in tau, or finally it is nothing but because of decreased volume. Decrease in volume is also 4.0136, and this is 4.038, almost same. This is matching. The volume almost match. So we can conclude that this fellow imbibit, he fail in the reactor or in the vat. Okay. So based on this story and this data, what revelation Dr. Watson planning to make? So he made all his calculation, and his revelation, what he revealed from this story, is this fellow has fallen into the reactor, and once he has fallen into the reactor, naturally he is not alive. So because his body is in the reactor and that occupied the volume of about 25 gallons, and because of that the conversion was reduced. Okay, we'll look into the next problem. 5.28. The data in table have been obtained on the decomposition of gaseous reactant A in a constant volume batch reactor at 100 degrees Celsius. Stoichiometry is 2A gives R plus S. Okay, gaseous reactant is there. 2A gives R plus S. So 2 moles giving 2 moles. What size of plug flow reactor in liters operating at 100 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere can treat 100 moles of A per hour in a feed consisting of 20% inerts to obtain 95% conversion? Now here stoichiometry is 2A gives R plus S, 2 moles giving 2 moles. So number of moles are constant. But if pure A is used, then epsilon is 0. 20% inerts are there. So you have to again calculate epsilon and check. It may be 0. You have to check. You have to just cross check with the number of inerts. Okay. So 2A gives 0.8 plus 2, 80% of A, 20% of inerts. What you get is 20% inerts as it is. 2 moles of A give 1 mole of R, 1 mole of S. So 0.8 will give you 0.4 and 0.4. So 1 minus 1, this is 0. So we have verified. CA 0 value. Mole fraction is 0.8. So pi 0 into 0.8 will give you PA 0. That is total pressure, you know. So partial pressure of A initial PA 0 will get from this. And PA 0 by RT is CA 0. So 0.8 into 1 divided by this value of R, 0.08206. At 100 degrees Celsius, convert it to Kelvin, 100 plus 273, and this value calculated as 0.0261 moles per liter. So the given data is tabulated here. This is data, time in seconds, and partial pressure PA in atmosphere. So from 0 seconds to 420 seconds, this is the data. We can find out conversion from this. XA is equal to 1 minus CA by CA0. It is same as 1 minus PA by PA0. So you know PA, PA0 is 1. So all values of PA will give you this values of conversion. Then minus ln of 1 minus XA. So kinetics is not known. So first we will test it for first order. If it is not fitting, then we can go for second order and so on. So we'll start with try with simple first order here. If you see the problem statement, data is given, the decomposition of reactant A in a constant volume batch reactor, the stoichiometry is given, 2A gives R plus S, and about the kinetics we don't know anything. So from this data we have to try to determine the rate law. So we'll try first order. So for first order integral method of analysis, what it suggests, you plot minus ln of 1 minus xa as a function of time t. So minus ln of 1 minus xa is equal to kt. This is batch reactor data, so we use batch reactor equation. And if this fits by straight line fit through origin, it is y is equal to mx form, y is equal to mx. If the data fits well with little bit of plus minus error, the slope will give you k. Now you can see here, there is some plus minus error, but still the data is fitting well, and y is equal to mx, so m slope is 0.0096. So data is fitting with the first order assumption, first order integrated form. That means it is certainly a first order reaction. So K is 0.0096 second inverse. Once again, you can see here 2A gives R plus S. So this stoichiometric coefficient, though it is 2, it is not telling us, till it is clearly mentioned that it is an elementary reaction, we cannot consider it to be second order. It order can be anything. So we have tested it for first order. Luckily, it is valid. The data is consistent with the first order. Else, we have to test for second order and so on, that we have done earlier for first order, second order. And many times we have found that it has a second order fit by integral method of analysis. If it is not either first order, zero order or second order with integral method of analysis, that means the order is not 0, 1 or 2, then you have to go for other trials. And most of the time then we will opt for differential method of analysis. For given concentration time data, you can find out the slopes at different values of CA, that will give you minus RA versus CA data. And from that, using ln of minus RA is equal to ln of K plus n ln of CA. So plot in y is equal to mx plus c form, and whatever n and k be obtained, we have seen that many times, that can be used accordingly. Okay. For this data also, you would have tried that. Still it works. So it is not, there is not that you have to use your judgment, which will give you easy solution. You have options to choose from different method of analysis we have studied so far. So K is determined now. What is V0? Volumetric rate Fa0 by Ca0. Fa0 is given. It is 100 moles of A per hour. Ca0 is determined 0.0261 moles per liter. Okay, so this value is in liters per hour. K is in second inverse, rate constant. So naturally we will convert this into per second. So this is divided by 3600, 1.063 liter per second. Now we have minus ln of 1 minus x is k into t. Now we are using this for plug flow reactor. Batch reactor data, we have determined k, rate constant, same reaction. So rate law will not change, rate constant will not change. Now we are applying it to plug flow reactor because we are supposed to find the volume of plug flow reactor. So t is will be replaced by tau, and tau is nothing but V by V0. And for 95% conversion, this is 3 minus ln of 1 minus 0.95 is 3. We want volume. So volume is nothing but this 3 into V0 divided by K. 3 into V0 divided by K. V0 1.063 liter per second. This is in second inverse. Okay. So finally, what we get is volume in liters 332.12 liters for plug flow reactor. 5.29. So we have to repeat the previous problem for mixed flow reactor. So very simple. You know the model, tau is equal to V by V0, Ca0 Xa by minus Ra. This Ca minus Ra can be written as Ca0 into 1 minus Xa. This cancels out. Okay, epsilon is 0 here. We don't have to consider. So tau is equal to Xa. This tau is Xa by 1 minus Xa and into K you have. So Xa 0.95, 1 minus Xa, 1 minus 0.95, K is 0.0096. Same as we have determined from batch reactor data. This is 1179.17 seconds. This multiplied by V0, which we have calculated in earlier problem. So this multiplication give you 2103.85 liters. You can approximate it as 2104 liters. 5.30. The aqueous decomposition of A produces R as follows. The following results are obtained in series of steady state runs. Data is given in the table. All having no R in the field state. So CR0 is equal to 0 always. From this kinetic information, find the size of the reactor needed to achieve 75% conversion of the field stream. 1 liter per second is the volumetric rate and field stream concentration is 0.8 moles per liter. So for plug flow and mixed flow, this is the data provided. Tau, Ca0, Ca. This data is provided to us and this is in moles per liter concentration and tau is in seconds. We know mixed flow reactor model. For MFR, minus Ra is equal to Ca0 minus CaF by tau. Okay. This is nothing but Ca0 Xa. So, you know this Ca0 minus Ca. For each run, this Ca is Ca final. Each run. So, divide by tau. So, minus Ra, you get this data. We have to make 1 upon minus Ra plot on y axis and Ca on x axis. As we have done in earlier problem. So, 1 upon Ra values are calculated. 400, 200 and so on. You make a plot of this and you start with 0.2 or 0.8, sorry. CA0 is 0.8 and 75% conversion means 25 will be unconverted. So 0.8 into 0.25 is 0.2. So 0.8 to 0.2. And we have to find it for mixed flow reactor as well as plug flow reactor. So kinetics remains same wherever you carry out the reactor reaction, whether in batch reactor, continuous reactor, plug flow reactor, mixed flow reactor. For a given reaction, as long as you maintain the temperature and pressure conditions, rate law is not going to change, rate constant is not going to change, order is not going to change. Performance will be different in different reactors. So for mixed flow reactors, this tau p and tau m, okay, v or this v0, whatever we call volumetric rate, is 1 liter per second. So tau is v by v0, v0 or v value is 1. So in this case, whatever the value of tau you get from the plot, same will be the volume, because this is 1. So tau m multiplied by this. So area under the curve, you have to count the number of rectangles carefully, then approximate these rectangles which are not complete. Somewhere it is 80%, 70%, maybe 20%. So roughly you have to count the number complete rectangles. So half makes 1, or this half and this 1, 2, 3, this you can count as 1, like that. So by eye judgment you have to count it properly. So number of rectangles multiplied by area of one rectangle, this is nothing but this unit and this unit on x-axis and y-axis. So tau p comes out to be 66 seconds. As I mentioned you earlier, there may be plus minus 2%, 3% error that will be acceptable. Tau m, you get single one value because it's the area of rectangle. So this is simply 0.6 multiplied by 400. So 400 multiplied by 0.6 is 240 seconds. As v is 1, vm is same value as tau m, that is 240 liter for mixed flow reactor. And for plug flow reactor it is 66, so volume is also 66 liters. So we have solved all 30 problems from this exercise, and in our next lecture we'll start with the new topic, that is these reactors, whatever we have studied in series or in parallel. So we will be using now multiple reactors. So mixed flow reactors in series, plug flow reactors in series, mixed flow reactors in parallel, plug flow in parallel, series parallel combination. And it is not that one type of reactor in series only. We may have one mixed flow, it is followed by a plug flow, or three mixed flow reactors of different sizes. Largest placed first and smallest first in the end, maybe you can reverse that order, and many such combinations are possible. And here onwards the things will go on much more complicated. So you have to study once again chapter number 3 very carefully, and this chapter, complete chapter number 5 and almost all the problems, so that it will be easy for you to understand next chapter, and not only the chapters but also the problems from exercise which are not very easy or simple to solve. And in this subject, once you know the solution, then it's okay. But if a new problem is given to you which you are going to solve, or you have seen for the first time, it's not at all easy. it's very, very difficult, and you will experience that when you practice like that. So we will stop here and we'll continue with the new chapter in our next lecture.